takes advantage of your love is a man who doesn't deserve love at all. I have burdened myself with tangled thoughts of torture, torture that he deserves, torture that I would eventually give him. I stood out in the street, staring up at his window. I knew he had another woman up there. I wasn't quick to go catch them, though. I wanted to stay out in the rain. I felt too numb to move, and my heart felt like ashes, dropping down to my soul to a point where I couldn't breathe. So I stood there, trying to stop crying. My tears felt so heavy on my cheeks, and my stomach felt as if I had swallowed a jar of nails. I felt as if misery had punched me in the face and drowned me to death. Staring up at his window for as long as I've had now made my forgiving sadness start to disappear. I eventually felt my mad heart turn black. My eyes began to become obsessed over wanting him dead. And my thoughts wanted him gone. Right then and there, I knew what I had to do. I had to make him disappear. I was basically ready to stab away all the memories I had of us. So I did. The only thing I could remember after that was dragging his lifeless body down the block. It was really convenient that a cemetery was close by. While dragging his good-for-nothing body, my head started to have flashbacks of what had happened, but didn't want to accept the fact that I had done it. I guess you could say I was having a shorter breath of guilt. I dragged my bleeding beauty to the graveyard and didn't really know what to do next. I stopped and thought for a moment, and then it dawned on me. Nobody would be able to find him if his name wasn't the same. So I covered him up with some dirt and kept my eyes wide open while going back to our house to get the shovel, because you can never be too careful. When I got back, I started to dig and dig and dig. I wanted to hurry before the night was over. While I dug his final resting place, I couldn't help but think about all the good times we had. I dropped to my knees and I held my head in my hands, and I couldn't stop. I couldn't stop hurting. I have never felt pain the way this man has given me pain. I tried to pull myself together. I tried so hard to collect myself, but all I could remember was the look on his face as I stabbed him, and I stabbed him repeatedly until I felt his last breath on my lips. So I dug away everything this man meant to me, and I knew it wasn't going to be okay. I'd forever be haunted by the love that he once gave me, and that not only throws darts at my soul, but strangles my every being, and I hate myself for that. I then threw his body into someone else's coffin. The tombstone read Melanie Griggs. My tombstone would read Sinner.